What's going on, everybody? It's Mark here with another video, and today we are comparing two of the biggest flagship phones of this year, the iPhone 8 Plus, the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. These are currently the two biggest beasts in the smartphone world. So why don't we take a look at both, see what the pros and cons are of both, and then hopefully maybe you'll be a little bit more informed by the end of this video. So the first thing you'll notice is looking at the Samsung, it is a beautiful device. It is completely redesigned, whereas the iPhone unfortunately looks familiar. When I say unfortunately, some like this design, some don't. The moral of the story is it didn't change very much. They did release the iPhone X, the iPhone X, and it is a significant design change. So that being said, currently the iPhone 8 is kind of behind the Samsung in terms of design. So the second thing you'll kind of notice about both of these phones, well, primarily the Samsung, is how massive the display it is. It is a 6.2 quad HD display, whereas the iPhone is still just a 5.5-inch display. That's so embarrassing to say. It is a beautiful display, nonetheless. It's bright, it has true tone, and it's a very, very vivid display. However, with the side-by-side, the phones are the same body, pretty much shape, but the display is just significantly smaller. Not to mention the big chin and forehead of the iPhone. So taking a look at both phones on the outside, the Samsung has a USB-C port at the bottom, an auxiliary port there for your wired headphones, your lovely Bixby button, a volume rocker, and a hold button on the right-hand side. Fairly standard design in that aspect. The iPhone hasn't changed. Everything's in the same spot, and it still doesn't have an auxiliary port. Turning both phones on, you'll notice that there is no button on the front of the Samsung. With eliminating all the buttons on the Samsung's front, they kind of have to resort to having the fingerprint sensor on the back. Some people like it, some people don't. Nonetheless, it's on the back, and the way you wake up your phone is simply clicking the display. It is a tactile button, it's a virtual button, and again, the iPhone 8 is the exact same design. Home button in the front, quick fingerprint scanner, very easy to use. With the introduction of the iPhone 8, Apple finally introduces Qi wireless charging. Samsung's had this for a while, but where Samsung also beats the iPhone in this case is wireless quick charging. Both of these devices support wireless charging, and both of them support quick charging, but the Samsung's the only one that supports wireless and quick charging together. A lot of people don't appreciate the iPhone 8, and they keep resenting the fact that it looks exactly like the iPhone 7 and 6. However, internally, this phone is a complete redesign, and it gets a lot of heat for being a 6-core while the Samsung is an 8-core, but realistically, no one actually cares about specs. The only thing you'll notice is both of these phones are ridiculously smooth. But moral of the story, everything is super quick on both of these devices. You will never notice a little bit of a hiccup. Everything's gonna be smooth, it's gonna be quick, gaming, multitasking, everything you do here is gonna be buttery smooth. So both of these cameras have a 12 megapixel camera. The real battle comes down to personal preference. I'm gonna show you guys a few photos, both taken somewhat of the exact same object with both the iPhone and the Samsung. You guys can be the judge. One thing I did notice is that sometimes the iPhone does get a little bit overexposed, and sometimes the Samsung's a little bit oversaturated for my personal taste. You guys be the judge. Let me know down in the comment section below. But where the iPhone takes the lead is in video. Not only does the iPhone now do 1080p at 240 frames per second, it does 4K at 60 frames per second. That out of a smartphone is just ridiculous. So we use our smartphones as entertainment devices. One of those forms of entertainment comes down to video consumption and audio. So Apple has made significant improvements to their speakers. I just want to do a quick little comparison versus the iPhone 8 Plus to the Samsung S8 Plus. See which speakers kind of take the lead in this one. Okay, so the only thing I kind of noticed was that the iPhone's a little bit louder than the Galaxy S8 Plus. Quality-wise, maybe the iPhone's a little bit deeper, maybe this one's a little bit more mid-range. Comes out to personal preference again. They're both amazing devices. What can I say? They're both the flagship devices of 2017 at the moment. I can't say anything bad about both of these devices. One last comment about the Samsung. I still don't understand the point of Bixby. At least now you can turn her off. All right, so that's a little bit of a comparison between the iPhone 8 Plus and the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. If you like this video, please hit that like, share, and subscribe button down below. And for additional brownie points, please follow me on all my social media. Links can be found in the description. But for now, thanks, and I'll see you on the next one.